Please all abide. Good afternoon and welcome to St. Joseph's for this great celebration. Something which everybody can never get enough. So let us pray. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness pour out your grace on these your servants, David and Michaela, that coming together before your altar, firm in love for one another. Our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated and ask Anna please to come forward for the first reading.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air, and he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be his name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all the wild animals, but none proved to be the suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man, and while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one, at last, is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of her man, this one has been taken." That is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one body. The word of the Lord.
The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. Blessed the nation whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen for his own inheritance. But see, the eyes of the Lord are upon those who fear him, upon those who hope for his kindness. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and shield, for in him our hearts rejoice. In his holy name we trust. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. May your kindness, O Lord, be upon us, who have put our hope in you. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord.
Would Patty Hayes please come forward for the second reading?
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, put on, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If one has a grievance against another, as the Lord has forgiven you, so must you also do. And over all these, put on love. That is the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which you were also called in one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, as in all wisdom you teach and admonish one another, singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with gratitude in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, in word or in deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. God is love. If God loved us, we also must love one another. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said, from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Said them down. They were But you could tell they were in their 80s, and they were sitting there, and she looked over and said, my goodness, this is a lovely old couple. They must be so much in love. And then she forgot about them because there was her future husband there. And talk, 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 and about 20 minutes later, she looked over again. They're still just sitting there, not talking. So they sort of heard, that's odd. We got lots to talk about, she thought. Well, never mind. Here's my love. Chatter, chatter, chatter. And 10 minutes later, they're still sitting there, like mummies. They're sitting there, staring at each other. If this is love, I don't know what love is. This is just can't be love. Look at them. They're just, maybe they just, she didn't know what she was thinking. And then, well, they had ordered cheese blitzes came, and the cheese blitzes got cold, and what eventually ate them again, and always kept on looking, and they were just sitting there like rocks. She got pretty mad on the inside. How can they stick together like this if there is no love in their life? So eventually they finished up and got up and walked out. He sucked the pay, and as she was looking, she ran right into him and dropped the purse, and so everything scattered. I don't know how many things they got in there, by the lots of it, so she put it all together. And before she got back up with her purse, she looked over to the couple to give them a look again, and then she stopped. Because Cody didn't say a word, they had their hands joined underneath the table. No words are needed when you're in love. Over time comes less talking, more loving, and that's what real love is. When you come to the church, you're here not just to bombard God with what you need and what you want. You come here to enter into silence, so that in the silence you enter into the presence of God. And in Catholic churches, we have a crucifix up there. The crucifix is what you usually look very close. He hangs there. And he, as he hangs there, even talks to us, even now. If you look very close, he's got his arms stretched out. One hand is like one and the other one three. We are one God, three persons. This is what the image of marriage is. A union of Christ with the church. Church united with Christ, entering into this oneness of God, but yet being different persons altogether. So they are entering now into this one family, and two right now, but I know God has plans for them, and the football team is not too much to ask, is it, Lord? They might have to get another house. But life is good. Love is very good. So life is something we have to enter into Christ. And every person, that's why each one is baptized individually. You are brought into Christ one by one. For those who are open, the hearts are being changed. You start to think and act not humanly anymore, but everything you do becomes out of love for the other. You go through life together. That's what God put them together. And, oh, you're so happy. And after about a few months, well, they get to know each other real well. And so what God usually sends a little distraction, so they have a little diversion. They don't look at each other that much anymore. But even the kid, and through the kid, they find each other again. And then the second kid, and so God keeps going and giving. Always looking out for the good of the other. But the thing is, what is the good? It's not breakfast in the morning, served in bed, but that's nice. But it is to bring the other into oneness with Christ. If you love God, you love your spouse so much that you want your spouse to be with God. This is the good of the other. The children we have, what is their good? Their good is the same as God himself. And that's why we baptize, and that's why we bring them together, to bring them to church, so that they come to know and love one another. It took them time to find each other and get to know. So it is with God. So they're an example to us now. Christ is the bridegroom of the church. This is what we see here now. He will lay down his life for the bride and for the family, and she will make it a home. So together, they build this community of love, and love is something out of this world. It is what credit cards can pay and say, It is priceless. Love is beyond this world. It is God. So, before they change their mind, you'll ask them, please come to the center. And the groomsmen and bridesmaids, please come forward. My dear friends, you have come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister and this community. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism and now enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. So in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. David and Jayla, as you come here freely without reservation to give yourself to each other in marriage, will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives? Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church? You have declared your consent before the church, for they are born in His goodness, strengthen your consent, and fill it both with His blessings. For God is joined, men must not divide. Now you can see the ring there. Oh, he did up there. Oh, we'll do that. We have to have someone. They didn't say yes to each other yet. Let's do it now. Yes, we didn't yesterday to practice. And I wouldn't let them kiss each other. Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and His church. I, David, take you and Jayla to be my wife. I promise to be true to you in good times and bad, in sickness and in health. I will love and honor you all the days of my life. I am in favor of taking you, David, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. Now you have prepared your consent for the church, and the Lord is going to strengthen your consent and fill it both with His blessings. For God is joined, men must not be divided. Now we will listen. May the Lord bless these rings that you give to each other as a sign of your love and fidelity.
For those who married yesterday, for David and Michaela today, for those who will marry tomorrow. May they live long, blessed lives together, and may their love grow stronger each and every day. Let us pray to the Lord. For David and Michaela's parents, who have shown and demonstrated to David and Michaela a loving relationship for their whole lives, let us pray to the Lord. For our country and those who defend it, may our men and women who serve in the military and in police forces be kept safe from all harm. Let us pray to the Lord. For farmers and all those who provide us with our food, may they have a safe and bountiful harvest. Let us pray to the Lord. For all of our guests gathered here today, may they enjoy the warm company of family and friends and have safe travel on their journey home. Let us pray for the Lord. For our relatives and friends who have gone before us to the other side of life, may they know the peace and fullness of eternal life with God. Let us pray for the Lord. Father, these are our words of prayer today for ourselves and for all peoples. Lord God, the beloved of mankind, who has first loved us, give our words the power of your words, so that all things may be accomplished sweetly and gently for the happiness of all. We ask this and pray through Christ our Lord. Amen. And there's one more important thing to do, and this is the blessing of the couple. Now, when you became a Christian, you have received a very special power to bless. At night when you are at home, you bless your spouse before you go to bed, you bless the children, you bless the food, you bless everything in sight, even the dog. Thank you, because the less pleased. But blessing is a gift. Each one has that. So I ask this to stand with me, extend your right hand upon the couple, and we will bless them for the right. Please respond with amen. May Almighty God, with his word of blessing, unite your hearts in an ever-ending bond of pure love. May your children bring you happiness, and may your generous love for them be returned to you many times over. May the peace of Christ live always in your hearts and in your home. May you have true friends to stand by you, both in joy and in sorrow. May you be ready and willing to help and comfort all who come to you in need, and may the blessings promised of the compassion be yours in abundance. May you find happiness and satisfaction in your work. May daily problems never cause you undue anxiety, or the desire for earthly possessions dominate your lives. But may your heart's first desire be always the good things waiting for you in the life of heaven. The Lord bless you with many happy years together, so that you may enjoy the rewards of a good life. And after you have served the Lord in his kingdom on earth, may he welcome you to his eternal kingdom of heaven. May you bless the mighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon him and you forever. Amen. Holy Savior, Lord, we would like to thank you for coming. And the family, after the entourage has moved outside, family, please remain back here for photos and pictures. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, they present to you David and Michaela, husband and wife.